And thank you so much. This is a wild card entry. In the morning, Bansi sir said me to deliver this talk, and this topic is intelligent use of OHA in day-to-day practice. So first of all, we have to understand what is intelligent. Intelligence is not always necessarily costly, not new, not imported, but intelligence is something that can be specific, that can be measurable, that can be achievable, that can be relevant, and that can be done in a time slot. So it should be a smart choice and intelligent. I would show my gratitude and heartiest congratulations to Bansi Sabu sir for this wonderful, extravagant and superb scientific feat for all the members who attended this Diacon 2022. This was a brainchild of Dr. Urman Dhruv sir, and along with Bansi Sabu sir and Rajiv Chawla sir, they made this RSSDI ESI therapeutic wheel, which is actually an intelligent tool for all the clinical practitioners who are using diabetic medicines. There is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, which stands for A for age of the patient, B for BMI, C for CKD, D for duration of diabetes, E for established ASCVD, F for finance, G for glycemic status, and H for hypoglycemia. Before prescribing medicine for any patient, you must take care of these H parameters. The age of the patient, we are seeing a patient of type 2 diabetes in teens right now, and we have a patient who has a diabetes since last 50 years, so the medicine wouldn't be same for both of them. BMI, we are talking about diabesity. We are in an era where there is so much obesity in our population, and we are talking about kuposhan, where we have a two extreme, undernutrition as well as overnutrition. So BMI we must consider before prescribing any medicine. CKD, in diabetic patient there is a risk of CKD, and we must see EGFR, albumin creatinine ratio, before prescribing any medicine. D for a duration of diabetes, a newly detected diabetes and a decade old diabetes won't be the same for prescribing medicine. E for established ASCVD. We are all aware of CAPTCHA study, and we saw that 1 out of 3 diabetic is having established ASCVD, but not all the patient with established CVD receiving the medicine which are proven for beneficial in CVD patient. E for F for finance. In India, finance is a very relative or subjective things. Many patients who are coming in Audi or Mercedes, when paying a bill of doctor, they became poor. Then glycemic variability, glycemic status. For A1C of 8 and A1C of 11, there wouldn't be a same therapy. And then H for hypoglycemia. For receive any benefit, we should not harm our patient. There must be no hypoglycemia when we are treating diabetes and getting A1C target very low. So we must take care of all these 8 factors. Let's take some patient and some example to use this smart and intelligent RSSDI therapeutic wheel. And this is a 48-year-old businessman with type 2 diabetes, since 3 years using metformin 1 gram. A1C is 8.4, and he clearly says that my attempt for achieving a lifestyle modification is very unsuccessful. He is hypertensive, on ramipril, declined for injectable, obese, BMI 32, blood pressure 142/84, and shows signs of insulin resistance in terms of acanthosis nigricans. His ECG is normal, so what next we should provide to him? Now catch is duration of diabetes 3 years and BMI is 32. So young age, we can use any medicine. For high BMI, we must take care that we use the molecule which should reduce his BMI and weight, and duration of diabetes short, and oral therapy is required. So in this A, B and D, we must focus on SGLT2, GLP, DPP4 and AGI, and now with the availability of oral semaglutide, we must provide the full benefit of that molecule to our patient. In this patient, our options are early glycemic control by 2 to 3 agent will be beneficial, and it is clear by verified trial. We should first of all up titrate the dose of metformin up to 2 gram. That can provide glycemic control and marginal weight reduction. So SGLT2 inhibitor with use of GLP-1RA would be the choice in this patient. Again, our next patient with a 70 years smoker, documented atherosclerosis in carotid as well as coronary, duration is 12 year, no history of hypoglycemia, taking glimepiride 2 milligram with metformin 1 gram, A1C 8.6 and BMI of 31. He had MI, he is having microalbuminuria and multiple vascular risk factor. So in this patient, our catch is age, established ASCVD, duration of diabetes and BMI 31. So with old age, high BMI and high duration of diabetes with established ASCVD, we can see in RSSDA therapeutic wheel what are the available options. And we have SGLT2 inhibitor, GLP-1RA, DPP-4 inhibitor, and yes, pioglitazone. So what we can do in this patient, we can add SGLT2 inhibitor, which is a better option for established CVD, high BMI and old age. If patient is affording, we can provide a GLP-1RA either in oral or injectable therapy for old age. Yes, DPP-4 is one of the safest molecule, and as Salini ma'am has said, pioglitazone must be in prescription if we are treating high insulin resistance. We should continue with glimepiride and metformin and focus on CV safe medicines. What are the evidence? These are some evidence which shows that SGLT2 inhibitor and GLP-1RA are CV beneficial, and there are also a list of CV neutral medicines. And all CVOT says that DPP-4 inhibitor and SGLT2 inhibitor are very, very useful in terms of reduction of a 4-point MACE. I'm taking a very fast because we have very lesser time. Third case is a 60-year-old female, 7 years of diabetes, metformin 1.5, she is hypothyroid, receiving levothyroxine, atorvastatin and aspirin. Her adherence for medicine is questionable. She is open for injectable therapy, she had an inferior wall MIs few years back, and her BMI is 30. So in this patient, when there is a duration is 7 years, BMI of 30, her creatinine and EGFR shows that she is having CKD and all inferior wall MI. So with old age, high BMI, CKD, more duration of diabetes and already established ASCVD, what are the available options we can see in RSSDA therapeutic wheel? We can have SGLT2 inhibitor, GLP-1RA, DPP-4 inhibitor, sulfonylurea, and of course insulin. For SGLT2 inhibitor in CKD, we have now robust evidence that they are beneficial in the halt of progression of albuminuria as well as EGFR. Yes, GLP-1RA is also beneficial, and DPP-4 inhibitor, sulfonylurea and insulin are neutral. Case 4 is a 60-year-old hypertensive businessman, duration of diabetes is 7 years, BMI 29, having dyslipidemia, MI 3 years ago, and now compensated, there no angina right now. He is keen on his weight reduction and open to opt any therapy, currently on sulfonylurea and metformin, but he is having episode of hypos twice in last 3 months. His A1C is 8.2. So now the catch is hypertension, middle-aged man, MI 3 years back, on sulfonylurea, metformin, and having hypos at the A1C of 8.2. So according to the RSSDA therapeutic wheel, when we use it intelligently, we can see the age, established CVD and hypoglycemia must be the factor we take into the consideration. So what are the available options? There is a SGLT2 inhibitor, GLP-1RA, pioglitazone, AGI and DPP-4 inhibitor. On sulfonylurea and metformin, we must be aware that modern sulfonylurea are CV neutral and low risk of hypoglycemia. Still in this patient who experienced hypo at the HbA1c of 8.2, we can provide SGLT2 inhibitor as a low risk of hypoglycemia and established CVD and at the age of 60 years. We can also use DPP-4 inhibitor, pioglitazone, AGI and GLP-1RA. This is a fifth case, which is a 58-year-old female, duration of diabetes is 11 years, reluctant on insulin therapy and injectables, poor financial background, lipids are normal, there is non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, there is established CV coronary artery disease, BMI 24 and already taking DPP-4 inhibitor with metformin, A1C 7.9 and EGFR is 49 ml per minute per body surface area. So now the catch is duration of diabetes, high glycemic load, reduce EGFR, reluctant on insulin and injectables, poor finance and already having retinopathy. So in CKD, duration of diabetes and established CVD, what are the available options? SGLT2 inhibitor, AGI and pioglitazone. In this patient, we must continue DPP-4 inhibitor plus metformin, as metformin is a CV beneficial and DPP-4 is a CV neutral and can be given at a reduced EGFR. Additional use of pio, AGI and SGLT2 inhibitor, we can plan according to her financial status. And this is the last case, who is a 46-year-old male, a shop serviceman, 3 years old diabetes, A1C 9.1, EGFR 88, reluctant on insulin or injectables, normal lipid profile, BMI 24.8, and he is having newly detected diabetes. So in this patient, when we see RSSDA therapeutic will, we have to see for finance and glycemic status. And we have the choice of sulfonylurea, SGLT2 inhibitor, pioglitazone, DPP4 inhibitor, and insulin. And there is a ADA guidelines which says that when we need a low cost, high efficacious therapy, we have metformin, we have pioglitazone, and we have newer generation sulfonylurea. And when there is severe glycemic load, we can use insulin as well. Our mentor, Bansi Sabu sir, Rajiv Chawla sir, and Urman Dhruv sir, not only gave us this RSSDI therapeutic wheel, but they also validated this RSSDI therapeutic wheel in 2018 National RSSDI in Dr. MMS Ahuja Hall. And after that, we have a data across the country, North, East, South, West, and Central India. And then we published this article in IJDDC, which shows that validation of RSSDI therapeutic wheel with clinical experience of Indian physician, what our clinicians are practicing and what our RSSDI guidelines says. And it says that we are very up to the mark in using this RSSDI therapeutic wheel. With that, I would like to thank you all for silent listening.